The charges, sir, I'll hear them again.
My lord, His Majesty's court contends that the defendants, Mary Read and Anne Bonny, did piratically, feloniously, and in an hostile manner attack, engage, and take 7 certain fishing boats. Secondly, this court contends that the defendants lurked upon the high seas and did set upon, shoot at, and take 2 certain merchant sloops, thus putting the captains and their crews in corporeal fear of their lives.
Edward James Kenway, born of motley parentage in Swansea, to an English father and Welsh mother, married at 18 to Miss Caroline Scott, now estranged.
She's a beautiful woman, I am told, but not at all well these days.
If you touch her, you bastard, I'll...
Quite a surprise finding you here rotting in a Jamaican prison. We heard rumors that you had taken up with the pirate Roberts.
If you know the observatory's location, tell us now, and you'll be out of here in a flash.
Rogers can hold these British hounds at bay for a time, but this will be your fate if you fail to cooperate.
You, Mary Read and Anne Bonny, are to go from hence to the place from whence you came, and from thence to the place of execution, where you shall be severally hanged by the neck, till you are severally dead, dead, dead!
Oh, Ross!
May God in His infinite mercy be merciful to each of your souls!
We're pregnant! Do you all hear that?
What the devil did she say?
They plead their bellies, my lord.
Aye, you can't hang a woman quick with child, can ye?
Quiet! Quiet! If what you claim is true, then your executions will be stayed, but only until your terms are up.
Then I'll be up the duff the next time you come knocking.
Remove them!
What's your name? Billock? Kenmore? Conway?
It's Walpole, ain't it?
Walpole? Where'd you get that?
Well, that's the rumour going round. As dirty and daft a pirate as ever sailed these West Indies.
Well, whatever his name, got to make sure he suffers without dying. Orders from the governor. I'm back to the prisons at sundown.
And massage his feet if he's aching, shall I?
Quiet!
Oi! Stop, you twaddle! Hey! Stop
Open
me, a twaddle!
This gibbet.
Good morning, Captain Kenway. I have a gift for you. Do not mistake my purpose here. I have come for Anne and Mary, and you owe me nothing for this. But if you would lend me your aid, I can promise you safe passage from this place.
I'll need weapons.
You are comfortable with this, I am told. We must hurry.
Stop there, you!
You come back here! No, you don't!
Hold you.
Hey. You won't lose us that easily.
Stand still.
Alarm! Rouse yourselves, you dullards!
Alert!
Crushing it by some.
You!
The bastard's running. Interloper! Raise the alarm! Intruder! I need some help here!
You get back here. Damn it!
Interloper, raise the alarm!
We're not losing that bastard.
Oh,
Me, Edward.
Edward? Who's this fella?
It's all right, Anne. He's a friend. What's wrong with Mary?
She's ill.
And her child?
They took her. No idea where. Oh!
Oh! Oh! I know it pains, my lady, but we must be silent. Can you walk? Oh! Oh! Lean on me, Mary. Come on.
Search every cell!
Come on, that's it.
You're all right.
You should have been the one to outlast me.
I've done my part. Will you?
If you came with me, I could. Mary.
We'll be with you, can we? I will.
To Mary. What's wrong?
Is she gone?
What will you do now? Nothing sensible. You haven't earned this, but they suit you. Good fortune to you, Edward Kenway.
I teach him color first.
Will this do? In all your years out here, you could never achieve what I've done in 1/5 the time. Because you're a good man, Edward, see? Goodness is your disease.
That's my prize, Roberts. Now give it here!
Remember my creed, boy. A short life and a merry one, that is all. The world owes us nothing more than this. So take what you will, and then die before you live to see yourself made a fool.
Give it here.
That's right, boy, take it. I'll sweeten you, maggot. Calm, little puppy, and slink back to your kennel. You haven't the mettle for my brand of madness.
Robert! Welcome aboard, Kenway. It's prizes, plunder, and adventure ahead. Are you game? Out of my way, Ben.
Here's a glass to freedom, lads. Here's to gentlemen of fortune and women of leisure.
To a world full of rogues, better than all the kings of us about.
As gentlemen of fortune, we enjoy plenty and satisfaction, pleasure and ease, liberty and power. What man with a sensible mind would choose the former life? For I have dipped my hands in muddied waters, and, withdrawing them, find 'tis better to be a commander than a common man!
Down on powerful wings to see the freezing land and carried off to her nest. Flying close by, a jackdaw for the deed, and it filled his head with the idea that he too was just as strong and capable. So, with a great flapping and rustling of feathers, the jackdaw came down swiftly and clutched at the coat of a large ram. But when he tried to fly away, he found he could not lift the animal, for his size and strength were not up to the task. And even as the jackdaw struggled, the ram hardly noticed. Nearby, just across the field, the shepherd saw the fluttering bird and was quite amused. Running up, he captured the jackdaw and clipped its wings. That evening, he gave the jackdaw to his children as a gift. "What an odd little bird this is, father," they laughed and shouted. "What do you call him?" "This is a jackdaw," the father said. "But if you should ask him, he would claim to be an eagle."
"I think you've had enough.
Listen to you.
2 years. You promised me.
You left when I needed you the most.
But you had me. What keeps you wondering? Do I not make you happy?
I'm so close, Caroline. Please, just let me do this.
Is everything you do out of spite, Edward?
It's not spite that's driving me, Mary. It's courage.
Courage for what, man? There's no one left in your life to care.
God damn you. I can handle this.
Lout. Always tearing down when you could be building things up. Or building yourself up, if nothing else.
Just leave me be.
Change course, Edward. Change your bloody course before it's too late.
Captain Kenway, you look like a bowl of plum duff.
Christ! Oh, I've got a head for 10.
On your feet.
You put me on the spot, Addy. After leaving me with Robert, I should have hard feelings about seeing you here. But mostly I'm bloody glad.
Me too, brother. And you'll be chuffed to know your jackdaw is still in one piece.
Shall we set sail? You're leaving.
Aye, Edward. But I have another calling elsewhere.
Addy, listen.
When your heart and your head are ready, visit the assassins. I think you'll understand then.
Jesus, Addy, what the hell happened here?
You happened here, Edward. The damage you caused 6 years ago has not been undone.
I'm not an easy man to call a friend, am I? Is that why you're here?
To fight beside a man so driven by personal gain and glory is a hard thing, Edward. And I have come to feel the assassins and their creed a more honorable cause. Have I been unfair?
No. For years I've been rushing around taking whatever I fancied, not giving a tinker's curse for those I hurt. And yet here I am, with riches and reputation, feeling no wiser than when I left home. Yet when I turn around, look at the course I've run. There's not a man or woman that I love left standing beside me.
There is time to make amends, Captain.
Mary, before she died, she asked me to do good by her, to sort out the mess I made. Can you help me?
Mary was fond of you, Edward. She saw something in your bearing that gave her hope you might one day fight with us.
Aye, she told me.
And what do you think of our creed?
It's hard to say. For if nothing is true, then why believe anything? And if everything is permitted, why not chase every desire?
Why indeed?
It might be that this idea is only the beginning of wisdom, not its final form.
That's quite a step up from the Edward I met here many years ago. So what do you think?
It'll take some getting used to.
The second attack this month, I should have moved this village long ago.
I brought all this upon you years ago, but I will stand by you now.
It will take more than a few favors to call yourself a true assassin, Edward.
One thing at a time, mate.
Under attack once more. Come.
To the beach!
Stay close, Edward. Follow my lead. And once more you have our thanks, Edward. You are welcome here.
Thank you, sir. I'll rest here for a time before setting out, if I may. How's her child?
She is a strong woman, but not invincible.
Sorry for your loss.
If I'd stayed in prison, they'd have taken him from me. He'd never be alive. Maybe this is God's way of saying I'm not fit to be a mother yet. Carrying on like I do. Cursing, drinking, fighting.
You are a fighter, aye. In prison, I heard stories of the infamous Anne Bonny and Mary Read taking on the King's Navy together. Just the pair of you.
It's all true. Anne would have won that day if Jack and his lads weren't passed out in the hold from drink. Edward. Everyone's gone, aren't they? Mary, Bracken, Touch, all the rest. I miss them so, rough as they were. Do you feel that too? All empty inside?
I do. Devil curse me. I know my targets by sight well enough, but how will I find them?
We have spies and informants in every city. Visit our bureaus and the assassins there will guide you.
That fixes Torres and Rogers. Bartholomew Roberts won't be near any city. It might take months to find him.
Or years. But you're a man of talent and quality, Captain Kenway. I believe you will find him.
And if you're at a loss, do not be afraid to call on your quartermaster for aid.
Quartermaster, what's our present course?
Due west, Captain, if it's still Kingston we're sailing for.
It is indeed, Miss Bond.
Call it out.
Weigh anchor and let fall the courses, lads. We're sailing for Jamaica. I've barked louder, and to men twice as rough.
Tending bar at the old aviary, you mean?
Among other places. And I sailed with Mary in Rackham for a time, remember?
Of course.
Mary did most of the captaining, Jack did most of the drinking.
Did Mary... Did she ever tell you who it was that fathered her child?
It was a young fella. He sailed with us on that last voyage. Poor lad was killed fighting beside us. The only man not too drunk to stand up for himself.
There was so much about her I didn't know. I called her a friend. But was I one in return?
She thought the world of you, Edward. I've no worries about that.
Well, that's good to hear.
Lovely down below, boys. One more pull, don't you hear the mate a-ballin'? One more pull, that's the end of our hauling. Sally Brown, she's the gal for me, boys.
Hey!
Captain Kenway.
You have something for me?
The present whereabouts of the Templar Woods Rogers. He is attending a small political function, so do it clean.
The word is King George is calling Rogers back to London.
Aye, not happy with his progress in Nassau.
Still too many pirates roaming about from what I hear.
You'll need a disguise to fool the powderheads at this party. I suggest the visiting diplomat, Ruggero Ferraro. He's been on our list for some time.
Understood. Will you send this to England for me?
Aye. The ship leaves tomorrow.
Caroline Scott Kenway, Hawkins Lane, Bristol.
Everything!
There is no beauty to this city. No expression of joy. No aesthetic plan. You walk your streets like animals. Like cattle with no sense of decorum. Idiots. How you English believe you can subdue the world is beyond me. Even once a month. Mio Dio. Revolt.
Salve. Forgive the lateness of my arrival. I am Ruggiero Ferraro.
Hi, Mr. Ferraro. Not a problem.
Ladies and gentlemen, a toast to my brief tenure as governor of the Bahamas. For under my watch, no less than 300 of our pirates took the king's pardon and swore fealty to the crown. And yet, for all my...
Shite! Of all the...
He was a privateer once.
How is it you lack so much respect for sailors only trying to make their way in this world?
You couldn't possibly understand my motives, cretin! You have spent a whole lifetime dismantling everything that makes our civilization shine.
But I do understand. I've seen the observatory, and I know its power. You'd use that device to spy and blackmail and sabotage.
Yes. And yet all for a greater purpose. To ensure justice. To snuff out lies and to seek truth.
There's no man on earth who needs that power.
Yet you suffer the outlaw Roberts to use it.
No. I'm taking it back. And if you tell me where he is... I'll stop the man.
Here, at the edge of a blade, I find a friend in you at last. Principe, you mad bastard. Our best sources say Principe.
What happened?
Is Captain Rogers hurt?
That man there! The Italian! He did it! Thank you.
It's done.
Where now?
Grab your kit and pack well. We're sailing for Africa. Who did this?
It were a large vessel. The Royal Fortune.
Roberts.
Offered no quarter. Didn't say nothing.
Man on canvas! Let's move! Fire!
clear of that, Captain.
That's a good shot.
Get the mainsails into the wind!
Device with him that needs taking. I'll have to board her myself.
By Jove, Edward Henry, how can I not be impressed by the attention you pay me? May the best of we two sing praises of the second!
A merry life and a short one, as promised. How well I know myself. And what of you, Edward? Have you found the peace you seek?
I'm not aiming so high as that. For what's peace but a confusion between two wars?
Oh, you're a stoic then. But perhaps I was wrong about you. She might have had some use for you after all.
She? Of whom do you speak?
Oh, she who lies in wait. Entombed. I had hoped to find her, to see her again, to open the door of the temple and hear her speak my name once more.
Aye!
Talk sense, man. Oh, I was born too soon. Like so many others before.
Where's the device, Robert?
Destroy this body, Edward. The Templars. If they take me...